Namaskar. I, Dr. Vaniki Joshi Lohani, currently working as Assistant Professor in Department of Management Studies at GSITS Indore, a Government Engineering and Management Institute. In this session, I will focus on innovation in pedagogy, integrating ICT for effective learning. Following will be the outlines where we will discuss into how our education system has changed and how ICT integration in education system has led to the outstanding results. I will also discuss about the integration of ICT in pedagogy, which can be done with the help of supported by various examples and running models. I will also talk about popular tools of ICT and different methods and models which can be used to enhance our pedagogy. Education is very important for the development and growth of any society. Our education system is one of the largest, with the students enrolled in elementary and as well as in higher education system of the country. Higher education has grown exponentially in the past few decades to meet the demands of quality education for all. This aspect has further gained momentum due to swift advancements in information and communication technology. Demand for skilled and competent labor is ever increasing in the contemporary globalized society. In this backdrop, access to quality higher education for all has emerged as a determining factor for economic growth and development. Human society up till now has seen three major transformations. The first transformation was from tribal society to agrarian society, where the driving force was knowledge about nature, growing plants and innovation of tools. While the second transformation was from agrarian to industrial society, where the growth of industrial society was dependent upon the use of auto machines. But on the other hand, the third and the most important transformation began in 1990s with the introduction of computer technology in our day-to-day working, which after the millennia has become an integrated part of our life. The last two decades have witnessed the inclusion of ICT in higher education system all around the world. Though higher education system is very old in India, as modern higher education system in India began with the establishment of Hindu College in Calcutta in 1817. At the end of 10th plan, that is in 2007, there were 363 universities in total, while at the end of 11th plan in 2012, the number of universities had gone up to 493. And at the near end of 12th plan, there are more than 800 universities, which includes both central, state, deemed and institutions established under special state legislature act. As we all have seen that the teaching pedagogy initially was a teacher book monologue methodology, which has now completely changed into an interactive session between teacher and students. Information and communication technology, that is ICT, is an umbrella term that includes any communication device or application encompassing radio, television, cellular phones, computers and network hardware and software systems, satellite systems, etc. Utilization of active teaching learning methods, which also includes case studies, flowcharts, video assistants, online lectures, simulation softwares, etc. When such technological advances are used for educational purposes, namely to support and improve the learning of students and to develop learning environment, ICT can be considered as a subfield of educational technology. Now, various researchers and educationists all around the world understand the importance of ICT for effective learning and understanding of the subject at all levels of education, where it may be schools or colleges or universities, etc. One such model of interactive usage of ICT for better understanding of the subject and for effective learning was proposed by Lorillard et al. In 2000 as a conversational framework. This model demonstrated the productive and unproductive approaches to learning, which were found in the context of different learning methods using ICT. This framework represents the iterative interactions using ICT that must take place for conceptual learning to occur and can be applied at any level of learning process. The interactions in this model might involve a short dialogue with the teacher explaining something or suggesting a practical example and commenting on the student's performance at a much more attenuated period, covering several encounters like class briefing, class sessions, assignments, or various other debriefings at all the ICT platforms. Here, one can observe two distinct levels of interaction, that is discursive and interaction level. At the discursive level, one can see the model implies that the teacher's theoretical ideas about their subject leads to specific ways of passing that knowledge or articulation onto the students. While at the interactive level, teachers are influenced by the discursive interaction with students, which will in turn influence the learning task as they present to them. Lorillard et al. Further emphasized that the use of ICT helps in enhancing the results of these two interactive models. This model can help teacher and teacher educators to acquire a better understanding the ways in which teachers' pedagogical practices might be affected by feedback from its students and interactions with ICT environment. Initially, the usage of multimedia was considered to bolster interaction between teachers and students, which resulted in a meek understanding of subject. But in 1992, Alexander identified teaching methods and student organization as two major facets of pedagogy, which can be enhanced using multimedia. They were included in the Alexander's conceptual framework for education practice, where pedagogy was one of the most important aspects, which Alexander described as the root work to a fully comprehensive framework. His work suggested that the pedagogy of ICT should be understood within a broader framework of educational practice. What is observed in the classroom is only a part of this practice. Thus, illuminating good practices in teaching and learning with ICT required examining teachers' ideas, values, and beliefs about the subject and resulted in enhanced performance of students as they were actively involved with learning phenomenon. Smiths and Moji in 1999 performed an experiment in which students were randomly allocated to an experimental group using multimedia learning environment and a control group using traditional methods of teaching. Although no differences were found in gains, but the results showed that a significant increase in interaction between the teacher and students and between them during learning involving multimedia learning environment compared to traditional lessons. Hay-Megber report looked into the characteristics of teachers that were associated with good progress in students. They found out that the student's progress is most significantly influenced by a teacher who displays both high level of professional characteristics as well as good teaching skills, which led to the creation of good classroom climate. He further identified the basic characteristics of a good teacher, which when combined with ICT knowledge and multimedia usage in teaching can highly bring change in the performance of students in class as well as in examination. Megber in his report identified that professionalism, thinking, leading and relating to others as the main characteristics of a good teacher. Here, one can observe that thinking is further divided into analytical and conceptual thinking, where analytical thinking adds to concept building framework of the student, which was supported by traditional books and knowledge and various types of case studies. While in case of conceptual thinking, it supports the above knowledge with the interactive ICT learning and teaching students allied cases through audio-visual as it aids the learning process. In case where necessary, involvement of simulation and modeling was incorporated to enhance the conceptual framework. In case of passion for interactive learning, students were asked to build physical and virtual models using ICT as a method to familiarize them with various tools and to enhance their learning. Michael et al. And Reed et al. Performed a pilot study over students at various universities and observed that any conceptual knowledge, if assisted by a video clip or a video example, gives the students a better understanding of the subject. But in case of this kind of assisted knowledge, the video clip should not be more than 10 minutes long, as the students generally tend to lose focus after this period of time limit, and the retaining power also decreases exponentially. Friends, up till now, we have seen various experiments and researches as well as models which have promoted the usage of ICT in pedagogy. But it should be clearly understood by teachers that the usage of ICT should be made only to enhance the knowledge of the subject of students rather than using it as a substitute to provide basic information. ICT can be used in various ways. Some of them are as follows. Usage of interactive whiteboard, as it helps teachers in enhancing their lectures, as whatever the teachers write on the board can be directly printed and later on can be distributed to students, as this kind of facility is not available in traditional boards. Hence, efforts of making lecture notes by students is eliminated and he can now completely focus on what the teacher is discussing in class. Usage of PowerPoint presentation in class makes students use their audio and visual senses both at the same time and gives them a better understanding of the topic. Usage of pictures and images to illustrate the examples related to topic helps them to retain it for a very long period of time. Usage of videos and audio clips further enhances the retention of topics. Hands-on experience on working models, especially in case of financial and mathematical areas, gives them a better understanding of how numbers and variables work together. Usage of higher-order softwares like Marquee and Poplet, etc., where Marquee is a simple and intuitive online app that allows the users to share and communicate about images securely. It allows users to easily point at the part of the picture while talking about it and keep the discussions organized for teachers. It is a great way for teachers to facilitate critical and creative thinking through an online visual literacy app. By asking high-order questions, students are given opportunities to interpret, analyze, evaluate an image that could, for example, either be an advertisement or an artwork or a scene from the text. Poplet is a collaborative mind mapping app that can be used by several students to brainstorm their ideas, capture facts, thoughts, images, videos, and learn to create relationships between them in a visual way. Poplet is a great tool to use for building the field about a particular topic, such as what impact do humans have on environment. The popples that students contribute to the Poplet can be color-coded to identify positive and negative ideas of the facts about a particular topic, and can also be used as a visual thinking board for students to build profiles about particular character from a text they are reading or as a storybook for a script they are planning to film or create. Now, we will look into various methods of ICT which can be integrated to enrich our pedagogy. First one is development of a learning community. Once the teacher has given the idea of the topic in class and the audio-visual discussion has been done, the allied topics or the related topics of the secondary learning should be shared in an open space between teacher and students called learning community. Here, teacher can share some useful topics related to discussion, further learnings, and moreover, it can also act as an open space for various facilitator or mentor from various background who can come and give insight to students and solve the topic related advanced queries. This would help in developing the interest of students towards the topic and will help in achieving the higher standards of quality. Development of a virtual field station. If a person visits a place and finds something useful in that location related to his classroom study, then they can immediately capture it and later on use it as an audio-visual case study, which thereby helps the teacher to create a virtual field station for teaching in the classroom itself. Results have shown that this way acts as an effective substitute to a real life study in terms of development of students' knowledge and their understanding for examination purposes. Establishment of CLP, that is Computer Learning Partner. It all started as an experimental longitudinal study in University of California by Lin and C in 2011, where the curriculum and associated pedagogy for a semester-long science course that aimed to integrate the appropriate use of ICT. It was one of the few studies where the use of ICT was planned into the new curriculum and the process and outcomes were researched. Now, this design of CLP curriculum focuses on guiding the process of connecting, linking, and reorganizing so that students could concentrate on thinking about their experiences in productive way. Adding simulations to the curriculum helps students to integrate their understanding and apply their ideas in a broader range of problems. Just to make sure that the technology was intended to enhance the instructions done by teachers rather than replace it, so a tutorial type application were excluded. Typically, several different activities were in progress simultaneously. Students could choose to work either individually or in pairs or in small groups. SAMR model stands for substitution, augmentation, modification and redefinition. It can be challenging to keep up with the pace of technological advances and decide on how best to use the tools to transform learning into the classroom. In such case, effective learning, which is widely followed by SAMR format, is used. This SAMR format was developed by Dr. Ruben Petundra. It aims to support teachers to design, develop, and integrate learning technologies to support high level of learning achievement. It describes four levels of technological integration that increases in complexity and effect, from simple substitution that barely changes the function to a more complex redefinition at the top, where the use of technology can provide opportunities to create what would not have been possible without the technology. Now, effective learning in any environment requires good design, management, and pedagogy. The reality that a boring, low-order thinking task on paper will remain the same when it is substituted for an iPad, unless the iPad allows the opportunity to redefine and retransform that learning opportunity. There are extensive evidences of ICT in contributing to improved learning by students and researchers. The benefits include giving them the means of providing more powerful explanations, developing their confidence in their ability to communicate their knowledge to others, helping them to achieve more autonomy in their learning, and presentation software to develop students' presentation and literacy skills. Interactive whiteboards can be used to promote class discussions and students' explanation and presentation skills. However, all the evidences show that these benefits are dependent upon the way in which the teacher selects and organizes the ICT resources and how the use of these ICT resources can be integrated with other activities in classroom and beyond. The crucial component remains the teacher and their pedagogical approaches. I will now conclude my session by emphasizing on the fact that teachers' pedagogical approaches are in turn affected by a number of key factors. First, they are affected by the knowledge about their own subject. Secondly, there should be a clear distinction between teachers who use ICT as a resource to fit within a particular topic, and those who choose this resource merely to present their work in a new way without any direct application to the topic. Evidence shows that when the teacher uses their knowledge both of the subject and also of how the students understand the subject, their use of ICT has a more direct effect on students' goal attainment. On the basis of the research evidence and the case studies conducted for this study shows that there appear to be three main approaches to ICT taken by teachers, that is enhancement, complementary and integrated approach. Enhancement approach. In this approach, the teachers plan to complement the lesson with an innovative presentation methods to promote class discussion with the visualization of problems. In complementary approach, usage of ICT resources done to impart the students' learning, for example, by enabling them to improve their classwork by taking notes on computers or by sending homework through email from the teacher to home or by word processing their homework. In case of integrating approach, students' learning is enhanced because they are confronted with the challenges to their existing knowledge and given deeper insights into their subject which is being studied. The enhancement approach could improve students' learning through presenting knowledge in many new ways by promoting debates, encouraging them to formulate their own explanations. These different types of use require teachers to have an extensive knowledge of ICT, which can be able to fit its use either into the existing pedagogy or to extend their pedagogical knowledge so that they can accommodate ICT effectively in their teaching. In overall conclusion, it can be inferred that ICT, if used effectively, has an impact on learning, where teachers are able to appreciate that interactivity requires a new approach to pedagogy. Further, teacher needs to employ proactive and responsive strategies in order to support, guide, and facilitate learning. They need to monitor progress and maintain a focus on subject learning by structuring activities and carefully providing focused tasks. But a major part of the effective use of ICT lies in the planning, preparation and follow-up of lessons, and also in particular how the pedagogical thinking, which links the teaching style and the selection of resources of the activities and learning objectives. It is clear from all the above models and researches that innovation in pedagogy is possible instead of substituting or teaching work with ICT. We rightfully integrate ICT, which expands the knowledge base of students. With this, I conclude my session. Dhanyavad and Jai Hind.